T-Phone Arena is in Barcelona, here to check out Mobile World Congress, where there's going to be the absolute bleeding edge tech making its way into your hands this year. But did you know that it's the smart engineers at Qualcomm who are responsible for a whole lot of that hardware innovation? We'd like to take a moment to thank our sponsors at Qualcomm for helping us make this coverage happen. And now, on to the video.
Another Mobile World Congress means it's time for one more Samsung Galaxy flagship. The Korean giant finally unveiled the Samsung Galaxy S9 Plus at the Mobile World Congress in Barcelona, and the S9-S9 Plus combo could very well be the hottest Android phones this year. We spent some time with them at MWC, and here's what we think. The Galaxy S9 Plus looks more or less identical to the S8. It retains the same premium build, look and feel that made it look like a futuristic slab of glass and metal while refining things all around. At the front, the Galaxy S9 Plus sports a 6.2-inch Quad HD Plus Super AMOLED Infinity display with a pixel density of 529 ppi. Like the S8, the screen stretches all the way around the edges. The S9 Plus doesn't quite make the leap to an all-screen design, which would entail the use of a notch. But it still manages to look really good. There's the usual niceties like the Gorilla Glass 5 protection, and while the screen is the same as the S8, the brightness levels have been boosted marginally. The general button layout is essentially identical to the S8, and the phone continues to be exceptionally comfortable to hold despite the large display. The one big change has been the fingerprint scanner. Now placed below the camera module, it is infinitely more accessible than before. Now you'll be able to buy the Samsung Galaxy S9 in both Snapdragon and Exynos variants depending on the market. Going by historical precedence, we'll likely be getting the Exynos 9810 version in India. Storage varies from 64 to 256 GB and can be further expanded via the microSD card slot. Based on Android 8.0, the interface remains essentially the same love it or hate it affair. In fact, one of the biggest additions or changes has to be AR emoji, which as you guessed it, is a copy of Animoji. The app is able to create a custom 3D replica of you using the front camera, and these can be used as stickers across apps. The Galaxy S9 Plus ships with two camera units unlike the regular S9. The main 12-megapixel unit has a variable aperture mechanism that lets the phone switch from f1.5 to f2.4. What this means is that depending on the ambient lighting conditions, the phone will mechanically switch the aperture to improve low light performance or to prevent overexposing shots. The camera also gets 960fps super slow motion shots at 720p. Meanwhile, the secondary 12-megapixel camera acts as a telephoto lens. Now, a show floor is no place to really test out the camera, but at first glance, shots appeared really good and had the typical Samsung image signature. Other features include stereo speakers tuned by AKG, wireless charging, IP67 protection, as well as a 3000mAh battery with wired and wireless fast charging. With a seemingly never-ending feature list, the Galaxy S9 Plus could very well be the phone to beat this year. We'll find that out when we review the device. This was Dhruv Bhutani from Phone Arena. Thanks for watching.